before we have to start with the new lesson, parallel lines and their transversal. This is the lesson of the geometry. Before I will start this lesson, I have to give some basic points of the geometry. Already we learned, you learned that points in the lower standard, from 5th standard, 6th standard and 7th standard. Then also I am going to revise that points now. Then the first point is, what is meaning of point? Point is a dot. What you have to say? Point is a tiny dot. This point, this tiny dot is called as the point. Point is a dot which do not have the length and the thickness. This point do not have the length and the thickness and used to show the location. I will say that this is that point you have to feed the fan. That point you have to stick the sticker. Means you will use this point to show the location. So this is point P. This is the dot, and you will represent this as, you will read this as point P. Point P. So I will read this as point P. This is point K. So I will read this as point word, and after that you have to give the name K. Means for the showing the location you will use the point. Second concept, segment. Segment means, segment is in the form of the line. This is the part of the line. Segment is the part of the line. Segment is in the form of the line, or segment is the part of line. Segment is the part of line which has two fixed end. This segment has two fixed end. I will show this as this segment. These are the two points. When I will join these points like this, at that time segment will form. And these points are the two fixed. These points means these are the two fixed end. This segment will not extend. Means this will not increase, because segment is limited one. And so I will say that segment is the part of the line which has two fixed end and which will not extend to both the side. Like the line, this segment will not extend. This and these are the fixed end. So if you want to read this segment, at that time you will read the segment as seg AB or seg BA, one end seg. This is the another segment PQ. This P and Q are the two fixed ends, and you have to say that you will read this as seg PQ or seg QR, one end same. If you will read the seg PQ and seg QR, the meaning is one end same. Then you have to come to the next concept, line. This is the line. This line has these arrows to both sides. This line also has the arrows to both sides. This line has the arrow to this side. This will continuously increase to this side. This will continuously increase to this side. So if you want to read the line, at that time you will read the line by the single letter. Or if you want to read the line, if the two points are given, at that time you will say that this is the line AB or line BA. You will read this as line L. This line you will read as line L, and this line you will read as line AB. Everybody understand? And what is the definition of line? Line has the arrows to both side, and it will extend to both the arrow side with no limit. Means this line has the arrows, and what is the indication of the arrows? This line continuously will extend to the both the sides. Means due to the arrows, this arrows will indicate that this line will increase and increase and increase continuously to this side, and this end also this will continuously increase. Means this with no limit this line will increase, but this segment has the limitations, because this has the two fixed end. This do not has the two fixed end. Okay, this has the two arrow ends, and this line will extend to both the arrow ends continuously. This segment will not continuously extend to the both the sides. Then next concept is ray. Ray is also the part of the line. This is part of the line. If I will say that this is the line, if I will cut this arrow end, and if I will give the name OA, at that time this is called as the ray OA. Every time you have to read the OA, ray with the fixed end. So I will write the definition of the ray. Ray is the part of the line. This is also part of the line. Has the fixed end at the one side, has a fixed end at the one side and the arrow end to the other side. This is the part of the line, they have the fixed end to the one side and another side, this has the arrow end. And it and always ray will extend only at the arrow end with no limit. And with no limit, this ray will extend only at the arrow end. This is the fixed end. This side, this ray will not increase, but continuously this will increase at the one side. Like the line will extend to the both the sides. This line it will extend this side also and this side also, this side also and this side also. But this ray do not have the arrow to this side, so this has the arrow to this side. So while this will extend continuously at the arrow end. And if you want to read the ray at that time, you have to read the ray with the fixed end. You have to read the ray as ray OA, not ray AO. Every time you have to read the ray as ray OA. With the fixed end, you have to read the ray. Then you have to come to the next concept, angle. What is the meaning of angle? Here, this is the fixed point. When two rays intersect at one common point to form the angle. This is the common point of this ray OA and this is the common point of this ray OB. When they will intersect at point O, means this ray and this ray will intersect at point O, at that time whatever be the diagram will form, that one is called as the angle. When two rays intersect at one common point to form the angle, if you want to read the angle at that time with the arrow end, you have to start, you will read the angle as angle AOB. This is the symbol of angle. This is the symbol of angle. You will read this as angle AOB or angle BOA, AOB or BOA. Before that you have to give the angle sign and you will read the angle like this. Everybody understand? This is the angle. Means when two rays intersect at one common point, at that time whatever be the diagram will form, that one is called as the angle. Then you have to start with the new concept, plane. What is the meaning of plane? Plane is the four-sided closed figure. If you will say that this is 1, 2, 3, 4. This plane, this is the plane and this is the four-sided closed figure. And which extend at all the four sides is called as the plane. With the arrow ends, this arrow will increase continuously to this side. This arrow end is increased to this side. This arrow will increase this side. This arrow will, this side will increase with this arrow end like this. Means this plane do not has the limit. This plane is also the unlimited way this will continuously extend to all the four sides. I will say that this plane is, this board is one of the plane. This diagram is plane. And I will say that this board is also one of the plane. This wall is also one of the plane. Means plane is, plane will continuously extend to the arrow ends. And if you want to read the plane, at that time you will read the plane as, you will say that this is plane P. So read the plane as plane P. Plane P. So I will read this as plane P. And this is the four-sided closed figure. This will extend to the all the four sides with no limit. I think these points you understand properly and you have to learn this definition. Whatever I wrote, that you have to write in the notebook, and whatever I wrote in the box, that you have to write in the basic book properly. Thank you.